Miss Said, how do you feel now that you are in the European Union? Are you happy here?
Oh, I am absolutely honored and proud to be here. I had such a great opportunity yesterday to raise the voice of the voiceless women of Afghanistan with those words and the performance that I had and the message that I had. So I'm pretty happy and grateful to be here. And for me, the main message I just want to give out once again for the world, for the European Union, not to forget about Afghanistan and especially the women and children of Afghanistan who are in dire need of some help right now. Because, of course, Afghan women have been in misery for the past 40 plus years. But I think right now they're at the peak of that misery and the issues and the problems that exists. Right now, as you all know, women are not allowed to have a life at all, not work, no study, no education for children, for young girls. People are starving because, of course, we have millions of women who don't even have a man. They don't have husbands. And they are the breadwinner of their families. And if they are told to sit at home and not do anything, so how are they going to feed their children? And the problems are, like, you know, limitless. I don't know which one to talk about specifically right now. You all are aware of that. And please, the one thing I want to remind everybody not to get scared of the fact that Taliban and those extremists and the terrorists, they always try to scare the international community of the one word, religion or Islam. We are all Muslims. We believe in religion. We believe in God. But millions of people of Afghanistan, they want to, you know, have a normal life. They want to have a normal society. They want to live. They want freedom of speech. At the same time, they're Muslims. They would practice Islam at the same time. You know, being a Muslim doesn't mean you sit at home and you cover yourself head to toe. Even Islam doesn't say that. No. So I want you guys not to get scared of those words and those sentences that you hear from the extremists in our society, because those are not the majority. Sure. They're a minority. And as I said, the new generation of Afghanistan, the millions of people in Afghanistan, they're thriving for life, and please don't forget about them. Please don't forget about people of Afghanistan. And I already appreciate, you know, the fact that this conference was held yesterday. And this is a first step. This was a great step. And I hope that they will continue with this and they will not forget about my country and my land. And it's my wish. I still haven't given up on our land, to be honest with you. I still feel like, you know, some miracle is going to happen and we are all going to have our country back.